this day. For the same God who said, out of darkness let light shine, has caused his light to shine within us to give the light of revelation, the revelation of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. Where dwells the true and never failing light, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
There is one body and one spirit.
There is one hope in God's call to us.
One Lord, one faith, one baptism.
One God and Father of all.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Purify our conscience, Almighty God, by your daily visitation, that your Son, Jesus Christ, at his coming may find in us a mansion prepared for himself, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Thank you.
desire, nor you have neither desire, nor taken pleasure in sacrifices and offerings, burnt offerings, and whole things, and sin offerings. These offerings are according to law. Then he added, see, I have come to do your will. He abolishes the first in order to establish the second. And it is by God's will that he has that we have been sanctified for the offering of the body of Jesus Christ. Once for all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
In those days, Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zachariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud voice, blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord. And Mary said, my soul magnifies the Lord. And my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and to his descendants forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
If you have ever been to a symphony concert, anytime an orchestra has played a public concert, you know there are those moments just before the music begins when the conductor comes, steps up onto the platform, and lifts the baton. That is one of the most magnificent moments. What it does is it calls everyone's attention to what's about to happen. And a good conductor who understands that that lifting of the baton is part of the artistic experience of the music, a good conductor will not just sort of pick up the baton, but will make that gesture very deliberate and clear, because it is indeed a part of the whole performance. When we watch the baton go up and it pauses for just a moment at the top, we know that the music is just about to start. The fourth Sunday of Advent is that lifted baton. It is. We are knowing that the music of the Nativity of our Lord is about to begin. It hasn't started yet. But we know it's just about to start. And so we are paying a particularly focused kind of attention this Sunday. Isn't it wonderful that four candles are now burning? Maybe you can remember back those few weeks when the first candle was lit in the life of this parish church, as you all entered into your Advent journey of prayer and of expectation. Today on Advent 4, we have together the most exquisite opportunity to think of that baton, to think about the moment that is coming and our anticipation of that moment. We have good company. As we gather here on Advent 4, we have the company of an old woman long past the day when she could bear children. Her name is Elizabeth, and she is wondrously and miraculously pregnant. She had spent her whole life in shame because in her day and amongst her people, for a woman to be childless was a source of shame. So her shame has been taken away. She and her husband Zechariah have understood that God did something amazing to make it possible for her to become pregnant long past the age when most women have ceased to be able. Then we have another person on this scene who is a very young girl. She too is miraculously pregnant. She too has had no experience with a man, but yet she's pregnant. two women, miraculously pregnant, seek one another out. Out of the celebration that Elizabeth is feeling, the joy that is overwhelming her at her motherhood, and Mary, at the combination of joy, knowing that she will bear a child, and genuine fear for her life. Because in her day, women who were pregnant before marriage were often stoned to death. So think of the emotion in this meeting between these two women. The amazing joy of this woman long past her age of conception, possibility of conception, and this young woman, not yet married, aware that she's pregnant and fearful for her safety. Have you ever gone to someone in your fear, in your time of transition, in your time of uncertainty, knowing that going there to that person was part of being safe, that that was a person in whom and with whom you could be safe? I believe that's what Mary was doing. She knew this kinswoman, Elizabeth, in her advanced age. She knew she could go and be safe. And Elizabeth, in return, upon hearing Mary outside the house, calling to her, experiences something quite wondrous, and that is, she feels her baby move. And she knows why her baby moves. And so Elizabeth is probably the first person after Mary to know who Mary is carrying in her body. So Elizabeth acknowledges what she knows is happening and says, "How wonderful that my Lord's mother comes to me." She blesses Mary, "Blessed are you, blessed is the fruit of your womb." And then she says, "The babe inside me leaped for joy." The two women doubtless embrace, and then Mary sings a song, a very old song, by the way. She didn't write it. She was picking up old texts from the Old Testament of women who have had miraculous pregnancies, including a wonderful story of a woman named Hannah. And isn't it wonderful that we have a Hannah today to offer the sacrament of confirmation? In this moment of meeting between Elizabeth and Mary, all the emotion, all of the waiting, all of our expectation, all of our hope that a Redeemer will come into this place, this earthly life, filled as it is with tragedy and sadness, violence, but also wonder and joy and love, that God is going to come here to us in the form of a baby. And so watch that baton. It's right up there at the very top. It's about to start the music. But meanwhile, as we watch for that moment to come, Mary and Elizabeth are falling into each other's arms, speaking of joy, talking about what is really going on and what God is doing, what God has done in their lives, what God has done in Elizabeth's life to give her motherhood at her advanced age, what God is doing in Mary's life to bring the Savior, the incarnate Word of God, to birth in Jesus, and how they begin that wonderful process of forming Christian community. Those two women were the first Christian community proclaiming the Savior. Good company we have today, wouldn't you say? Amen. We move now into the service of confirmation. You will see it in your bulletin. my important items. Could I have my hat also, please? We have people presenting themselves today to be confirmed. And so I will ask all of you who are being confirmed to stand in your pew right where you are. Okay. The candidates will now be presented.
I present these persons for confirmation.
And I ask these persons for confirmation. If you would please take your vows according to what you see in the bulletin. Here is your first vow. Do you reaffirm your renunciation of evil? Here is your next vow. Do you renew your commitment to Jesus Christ?
I do.
Wonderful. Now, none of us can keep the vows we make without the love and support of others. So this third vow is for all of you and all who are able. Would you rise for your vow? Will you, who witness these vows, do all in your power to support these persons in their life in Christ?
We will.
Then let us join with those who are committing themselves to Christ and renew our own baptismal covenant. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the Apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil? Whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord.
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
Let us now pray for these persons who have renewed their commitment to Christ.
Deliver them, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open their hearts to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill them with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep them in the faith and communion of your holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach them to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send them into the world in witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring them to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God,
we thank you that by the death and resurrection of our Son, Jesus Christ,
So those of you who are to be confirmed, who are sitting over this way, come on up and bring your folks with you. Folks, come on up with your candidates. And if you could just go over there, kind of behind the piano, kind of push up against the organ there. And maybe some of you could go over by your priest, by the Advent wreath over here. Perfect. And I would ask the congregation, as each person comes to me and you're seated there, would you say a prayer in your heart for that person as each one comes to me? And whoever is first, come on up. And I need Hannah's people up here to put their hands on her shoulder and join me in the prayer. Defend, O Lord, your servant Hannah with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she come to your everlasting kingdom. Hannah, in memory of your baptism, we will anoint you today with chrism, which is used at baptism, and you've renewed your baptism with your vows today. So Hannah, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit, and you are marked as Christ's own forever. Defend, O Lord, your servant Jerome with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until he come to your everlasting kingdom. Jerome, in memory of your baptism, as you renew your baptismal vows today, anoint you with chrism. Jerome, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit, and you are marked as Christ's own forever. Defend, O Lord, your servant Dominic with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until he come to your everlasting kingdom. And Dominic, in remembrance of your baptism, we anoint you with chrism. You are sealed by the Holy Spirit, Dominic, and you are marked as Christ's own forever. Congratulations. Defend, O Lord, your servant newly with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more, until he come to your everlasting kingdom. Newly we anoint you with holy chrism, in remembrance of the baptismal vow you've renewed this day. You are sealed by the Holy Spirit, and you are marked as Christ's own forever. Congratulations. Those of you who are on this side, it's your turn. Defend, O Lord, your servant Amy with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more, until she come to your everlasting kingdom. Amy, in remembrance of your baptism, we anoint you with chrism. Amy, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit, and you are marked as Christ's own forever. Defend, O Lord, your servant AJ with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more, until he come to your everlasting kingdom. AJ, we anoint you now with chrism upon your forehead in remembrance of your baptism. You are sealed by the Holy Spirit, and you are marked as Christ's own forever. Defend, O Lord, your servant Kelsey with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she come to your everlasting kingdom. Kelsey, we anoint you with holy chrism as a reminder of your baptism, which you renewed today. Kelsey, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit, and you are marked as Christ's own forever. Defend, O Lord, your servant Zach with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until he come to your everlasting. Zach, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit, and you are marked as Christ's own forever. Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.